Good morning, welcome to End of Week News. It's Friday, the 11th of June. US inflation shock, testing the transitory narrative. Last night's much anticipated inflation figures out of the US came in even hotter than expected at 5% against a predicted 4.7%. This is the highest headline inflation print since August 2008, just before Lehman Brothers collapsed. More critically, the core CPI surged to 3.8%, the highest print in nearly three decades. Back to the 1992 recession. The problem is this time we have a very different backdrop. When the headline CPI print peaked in 2008, it was before a precipitous drop on the Lehman collapse the next month and the advent and start of QE1 in November. In 1982, when CPI reached nearly 15%, the Fed hiked rates to 20%. Indeed, if you look at the goods prices component of last night's print, it was 6.5%. Easily the highest since that same 1982 print during the 1980 to 84 recession. However, this time we've already had the Fed going full tilt with quantitative easing, rates at zero, and the biggest debt burden ever, and hence no ability to allow rates to rise. And so it should be no surprise that gold rallied, jumping nearly $15 in the session, and silver even more so, up 23 cents or 0.83%. Why no surprise? Real interest rates. We have had near zero Fed rates, US Treasury yield low and falling against raging inflation. Crescat's Ottavio Costa tweeted this morning. I'll just read this here. Last time real yields reached such low levels was in the 70s and policymakers called for a war on inflation. Today, they're welcoming it. In fact, a transitory propaganda has never been louder. This is perhaps the most bullish macro setup for precious metals in over 50 years. That chart here for the US 10-year real yield. As mentioned just now, despite this and April's hot inflation prints, US Treasuries actually bid higher last night, seeing yields fall to around 1.4%, the lowest since March. Such yields are historically in line with core inflation in the mid 1%, not the 3.8%. And so the bond market is deeply invested in the Fed's transitory inflation view and backing them further and further into negative real interest rates. Now that the market may well be right, this could be a reopening plus supply constraints transitory spike. And so we could see the sort of sharp drop-offs in CPI seen before off spikes, followed by monetary easing to get it back up. To do so when we're already seeing market extremes off the back of currently already very easy monetary policy, clearly keeps us much in the negative real rate territory and on a snowballing trajectory to a huge market crisis when the snowball eventually hits the wall. On the contrary, if, as many believe, this inflation is not transitory, the Fed will come under increasing pressure to taper quantitative easing, or the bond market takes control and we see rates rise beyond their control regardless. And we repeat, this is not just a US Fed issue. The same dynamic is alive here in Australia. Overnight, the Eurozone's ECB announced it will maintain its 0% headline and negative 0.5% deposit facility. This to promote even more bank lending and not depositing. Ongoing normal quantitative easing APP of €20 billion per month and ramping up at a significantly higher pace of the emergency QE or PEPP, Pandemic Emergency Purchase Program, of €1.8 trillion. Talk about the printers going brrr. Name an asset now that isn't being inflated by cheap debt and easy money supply. Ask yourself what happens if interest rates go up or the bubble is artificially inflated further. Gold ultimately has your back. In either scenario. And that's the week in news from Ainslie. If you are interested in the physical stuff, following the trend, jump over to ainsliebullion.com.au. Cryptocurrencies, ainsliewealth.com.au, and goldsilverstandard.com for our own crypto, built and backed by real gold and silver. Enjoy your weekend, everyone, and we'll catch you on Monday for more news.